Hello guys, welcome back to Ushi Gaming Channel. So finally, the Alchemist code is here. The global version. Yes, the global version. Okay, so if you want to know how to download this game, read the description right now, okay? The game is now in soft launch, only available in Sweden right now. But it is going to be globally available soon. I don't know when yet, but it's going to be like really soon. So, I actually randomly played it. I didn't reroll, and I cleared some quests already until this part. And I have 540 gems right now. So, if you are starting the game, the first thing that you need to do is to summon, right? And as for now, there are only 2 5 stars available, which is Sahar and Chloe. Yeah, only Sahar and Chloe, right? And the rate up is now for Sangetsu, Lamia, and Karis. Basically, these three are all good, the 4 stars one. All of them can go to 5 stars. The max rarity in this game is 5 stars, okay? Sangetsu is really good at full limit break. You can unlock the third job and things. Lamia is good too. Karis is good too. You can see the available units by looking at here on the unit charts. So there are so many 1 stars, 2 stars, 3 stars. All of these characters can go to 5 stars. For example, the main character, it can go to 5 stars. This one too, it can go to 5 stars. See? All of them can go to 5 stars. As for now, since it is still very new, there are not many 4 stars and 5 stars characters yet. Yeah, the only 5 stars, Sahar and Chloe for now. Sahar is a good unit for the damage. He is a Dark Knight, basically. He can do very high damage but remove his own HP. And he also has a skill attack that can do very high damage, and it can go even higher based on the amount of dead allies, which is kinda cool, right? And this Chloe is a tank. She can be very tough. Well, in Japan, she is actually a free unit. But okay, as for now, we need to get her from the summon. Okay, so basically, in my opinion, at this stage, you don't really need to reroll, but if you want to get a really good start with 5 stars, you can reroll. In my personal opinion, to get any of this, either Chloe or Sahar, good enough. Or if you are doing reroll and you are kinda tired, cannot get the 5 stars, it's okay to start with Sangetsu. This one is also good, Lovia. You will need to limit break her to make her good, but yeah, she will be good. So the unit that is good after limit break is called as late hero. I mean, the unit will be good after you play it long enough. This one is a healer. The second job is a healer, and the first job is crafter. This one is a long-range attacker, and this one is a good unit too. She got enhancement lately in Japan, a few months ago actually. And this one is a healer. This one is a dancer, debuffer basically. And there are many other characters, but if it's for the reroll, as for now, either Sahar or Chloe, Sangetsu. Lamia will be good later, not now. Lovia is also a late hero. Okay, so that's my opinion. So, since I've collected 540, let's do a summon. In this game, usually when they release a new banner, there will be something like this, step up promotion. We can do 10 summon with only 500 gems for step 1. Step 2, 1500. Step 3, 2500. But featured unit guaranteed. It's always like this. So if you are a free player and if you want to maximize your gems efficiency, maybe you only want to summon on step 1. Step 1, you get the unit, it's great. You cannot get the unit, it's fine. Let it go. Maybe you can do it until step 3 if the character release is super good. But if it's just something like, oh, new banner, okay, let's try it, 500 gems, get it or not, it's okay. Something like that. And the second one is 9 step premium summon. This one is definitely not for free player, but it is a good deal for cash player because you will get a lot of guaranteed 4 stars plus unit tickets like this. This is just the beginning. Later, when the game progress, They can even give you 5 stars guaranteed or even select summon ticket. You can choose the character that you want to get. Yes, it's like the unit of choice in global. Okay, so for now, let's do this. Yeah, 10 summon, 500 gems. This is one of the reroll ways actually. You play the game, get 500 gems, do 10 summon. If you can get 5 stars, it can be considered as done for your reroll. If you cannot 5 stars, you can start a new game and then collect 500 gems, do 10 summon again. Or you can just simply play the game until the tutorial. If you get 5 stars, you're done with the tutorial. But if you cannot get 5 stars, well, maybe you need to uninstall the game and install it again. Okay, anyway, let's do this. Red, please. Red is the 5 stars, by the way. Yellow is 4 stars. Hikunoja. Come on. Okay, yellow. Red. What? Wait. Oh, yes! So I'm done with my reroll. Okay, let's see. Alright. The next one. Chloe or Sahar, whatever. Chloe, okay. Ultra rare, okay. Yellow can break to red too, by the way. Okay, nice Sangetsu. So it's a really good start already, Sangetsu and Chloe. Karisu, okay, nice. Super rare. Okay, 3 stars. Actually, in my Japan account, I have so many full limit break 3 stars characters. Because of, you know, I did so many pulls already. I played long enough. Okay, hopefully it break to 5 stars. Give me Sahar. Red. No, it's 4 stars. Oh, okay. So that's nice. The result is nice. So with this, I can say I'm done with my reroll. 1 5 stars and how many? 3 4 stars. Okay, that's really nice. Okay, I can form a good 5 stars and 4 star squad already. But I will need a healer still. Yeah. So maybe only 1 5 stars, 2 4 stars and 1 healer squad. Let's raise the character first. We can sort it by rarity like this. And in this game, the character's level will be capped based on your account's level. So my account is level 11, right? It means that it won't go more than level 11. Okay, let's try. See? P level limit. Player level limit, basically. It won't go more than that. If I max this out, see, EXP required for this unit max level will be exceeded. Continue. If I choose yes, it won't go to level 12. So you need to play more and raise the level. For the healer, I will just going to use this one. This will be my temporary healer. I mean, once I get better healer, I will remove this one. Yeah, you will get a very good free healer on chapter 3 of the story, if I'm not wrong. You can get it free from the story. Do not forget to raise your main character, because main character is very important. Why? Because if he died, it will be game over on the story mode. And you can raise the job level by collecting these equipments. If you don't know where to collect, you can just simply click it here and how to obtain. You can do the quest to get the equipment. And the other thing is limit break. You can collect the shards from hard quests. Like this. As for now, since there is only one quest, you can only collect 3 fragments per day. Later, in current Japan version, we can collect 9 longest fragments per day. But for the characters from Rare Summon, normally only 3 fragments per day. And if you have enough level, you can evolve it. You can collect the material from daily dungeon. So for the game mode in this game, there is arena. and also multiplayer battle. Okay, it's coming soon, not available yet. Story, and the character story, basically it's to get the special thing for the character. Event, this one is to collect job tokens. Yeah, the name is job tokens. You will need the job tokens to get the second enter job. And this one, Alchemia Pot, this one is to upgrade the character. After you max the job level, you will need this to upgrade the equipments. Yeah, so that you can get better stats and things. And how to farm gem? Here, on the missions, there is daily, right? Do all the daily, and you will get a lot of energies. The swords, the green swords here, is energy. And if you want to farm gems, do story mode, and after every 2 episodes, you will get 50 gems. And there will be also event quests, training, and other. Basically, you can farm the gems from this. And if you do the daily, you will get a lot of energies. This game gives you very, very a lot of energy. For example, my maximum energy is supposed to be only 41, but I have 446 energy, which I can use it like all day playing maybe, because for the quest, as for now, we only need like 8 energies and so on. And the other good thing is, even if it costs 8 energy, if we get a game over, you will only lose 10% of the energy, which is only 1 energy. If the energy cost is 50, and if you get the game over or if you retire, you will only lose 5 energy instead of 50. So if it's only need 8 energy, if you retire or game over, you will only lose 1 energy instead of 8, which is great. Okay, so let's do this. And if you look at the quest missions, they don't give you gems, but they give you the other stuffs. So to collect the gems, collect it on the mission. The subunits will appear if there is any character died. You can hire mercenary too. Well, basically this is the friend, okay? And you can also bring item, recovery item, and so on. Okay, let's go. Let's do a quest. Okay, you can play it manually. You can click on the tile you want to move, or you can move it freely like this. So you can do it manually by choosing it like this, or you can do it auto like this. The AI in this game is pretty smart. See? Okay. And there is also double speed feature right here. It is only available in global. It is not available in Japan, by the way. If the missions will be game over if Logi died, you can basically put the main character behind and let the other character to move forward like this. If you attack the enemy from behind, it will be backstab and you will get more damage. Ah, this is combination skill, by the way. You will do more damage based on how many combination skills proc. Okay, you can notice it when the other friend character glowing blue. And after the turn's end, you can choose the character to face which way. Basically, this is just to avoid your character getting step back. Backstab, I mean. And you can heal. The range is very small because it's a free healer. There is Lisbeth, the free character from chapter 3. She's a really good healer, but not available yet, maybe? If you are using skill, you can see here the hearts. It need 12, right? Basically, this is the MP. You will need 12 MP to do this. And now, my character has 13 MP, as you can see on the top left. To collect MP, you need to do normal attack. Okay? Like this. Now, my MP is 17. That's basically how to collect MP. You need to do normal attack. What? Miss again? And if you do attack with ranged character or melee character from higher ground, you will be able to do more damage. And the element, there is element system here. You can see here on the left part of the screen. Basically, red wins against green. Green wins against yellow. Yellow wins against blue. Okay, so hit rate is 94%. But why I missed twice? And also, you can attack and then move like this. You can target the unit or use the spell, the AoE spell, on the ground. So if you are using it on the ground, if the character moves, you can miss your spell. It goes the same to the enemies, by the way. If the enemy do spell on you, and you step away, you can avoid getting hit by the magic spell. Magic spells has casting time here, by the way. Okay, so end quest. That's the battle. So this is very new, and it's still soft launch, not globally launched yet. And I will play this game, like seriously. And there are shops here. This is a place where you can sell the ingots for Zenny. You can buy materials here, or fragments, but you don't need to buy the fragments here actually. You can farm them from the hard quest later. If you want to, you can buy it, but golds here, even if you can get a lot of golds, they will go like really fast, so you will need a lot of golds here. Zenny, basically, Zenny. And here, on the beginner shop, you can buy the materials to upgrade your job, or you can buy skip ticket. Skip ticket is basically instant clear for the quest. Yeah, there is instant clear feature in this game, but you will need skip ticket for it, so you cannot spam it all the way. It will depend on how many skip ticket you have, and it is quite expensive. So yeah, use it wisely. You can use it to farm materials if you need to. And back to the unit part, you will need to raise the ability seed, by the way, like this. If you raise the abilities, you will be able to learn more skills. So let's raise the shields. Okay. You can just hold it like this. So what's the difference shield and basic shield? It is locked, the shield, right? But you can change this, the basic shield. So that's about the ability. And job, you will need to increase this. And there is gear, but I think it's not available yet because there is no summon yet for the gears. And don't forget to do this. Challenges. You will be able to get a rare summon ticket if you cleared all of this. I don't know about the global version, but if it's in Japan back then, after you cleared a series of these challenges, you will be able to get unit of choice ticket. I'm not sure about the global because it is might be different. Okay, so I think that's all. That's the first video for the Alchemist Code global version. Well, it is only still available in Sweden. Yeah, because it is still soft launch, not officially launched yet. If you want to play it earlier, you can read the description about how to get the game. If you are not in Sweden, I think you can only play it on Android device for now. Basically, you can download the APK and install it into your Android device. Okay, so I think that's all for now, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't. Subscribe now, press the like button if you like this video, and see you again next time. Bye-bye. The Alchemist Code Punch.